From Loretto Abbey, home to the Sisters of Loretto since 1928, and the Loretto Abbey Secondary School, and with the kind cooperation of the Toronto Catholic District School Board, the National Catholic Broadcasting Council presents Daily Mass.
Welcome to the celebration of the Daily TV Mass. And my name is Father Pat Fitzpatrick. The televising of this Mass is made possible by a contribution from three donors. The first is Cecilia Dewey from Saskatoon, Saskatchewan, for her husband Gerald Dewey on his 100th birthday today. With love from his wife, his children Debbie and Paul Swinton, Pat and Kathy Dewey, and their five grandchildren. The second donors are the children of John and Margaret Power from Holyrood, Newfoundland. In loving memory of John, who died on July 11, 2013, and Margaret, who died on March 24, 2017. Both John and Margaret were devoted viewers of the Daily Mass. And our third donor is the D'Souza family from Etobicoke, Ontario, for the repose of the souls of Sabina, Antonio, Monica, Liban, Joseph, Fatima, Cecilia, Louis, and Valentine. Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass. And today, we welcome the D'Souza family to Loretto Abbey. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. May the risen Lord be with you. Amen. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Our feast day today is that of the queenship of the Blessed Virgin Mary. O God, you made the mother of your Son to be our mother and our queen. Graciously grant that, sustained by her intercession, we may attain in the heavenly kingdom the glory promised to your children. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Our reading from the book of Judges. The angel of the Lord came and sat under the ox at Ophrah, which belonged to Joash the Abizite, as his son Gideon was beating out wheat in the winepress to hide it from the Midianites. The angel of the Lord appeared to him and said to him, "The Lord is with you, you mighty warrior." Gideon answered him, "But sir, if the Lord is with us, why then has all this happened to us? And where are all his wonderful deeds that our ancestors recounted to us, saying, 'Did not the Lord bring us up from Egypt?' But now the Lord has cast us off and given us into the hand of Midian." Then the Lord turned to him and said, "Go in this might of yours and deliver Israel from the hand of Midian. I hereby commission you." He responded, "But sir, how can I deliver Israel? My clan is the weakest in Manasseh, and I am the least in my family." The Lord said to him, "But I will be with you, and you shall strike down the Midianites, every one of them." Then Gideon said to him, "If now I have found favor with you, then show me a sign that it is you who speak with me. Do not depart from here until I come to you and bring out my present and set it before you. And the Lord said, I will stay until you return. So Gideon went into his house and prepared a kid and unleavened cakes from an ephah of flour. The meat he put in a basket, and the broth he put in a pot, and brought them to him under the oak and presented them. The angel of God said to him, take the meat and the unleavened cakes and put them on this rock and pour out the broth. And he did so. Then the angel of the Lord reached out the tip of the staff that was in his hand and touched the meat and the unleavened cakes. And fire sprung up from the rock and consumed the meat and the unleavened cakes. And the angel of the Lord vanished from his sight. Then Gideon perceived that it was the angel of the Lord. And Gideon said, help me, Lord God, for I have seen the angel of the Lord face to face. But the Lord said to him, peace be to you. Do not fear. You shall not die. Then Gideon built an altar there to the Lord and called it, the Lord is peace. The word of the Lord.
The Lord speaks a peace to his people. The Lord speaks a peace to his people. Let me hear what God the Lord will speak, for he will speak peace to his people, to his faithful, to those who turn to him in their hearts. The Lord speaks a peace to his people. Steadfast love and faithfulness will meet. Righteousness and peace will kiss each other. Faithfulness will spring up from the ground, and righteousness will look down from the sky. The Lord speaks a peace to his people. The Lord will give what is good, and our land will yield its increase. Righteousness will go before him and will make a path for his steps. The Lord speaks a peace to his people. Alleluia, 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 alleluia. Jesus Christ, Christ was rich, but he became poor, to make you rich out of his poverty. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "Truly I tell you, it will be hard for a rich person to enter the kingdom of heaven. And again I tell you, it is easier for a camel to go through the eye of a needle than for someone who is rich to enter the kingdom of God." When the disciples heard this, they were greatly astounded and said, "Then who can be saved?" But Jesus looked at them and said, "For mortals it is impossible, but for God all things are possible." Then Peter said in reply, "Look, we've left everything and followed you. What then will we have?" Jesus said to them, "Truly I tell you, at the renewal of all things, when the Son of Man is seated on the throne of his glory, you who have followed me will also sit on 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. And everyone who has left houses or brothers or sisters or father or mother or children or fields for my name's sake will receive 100-fold and will inherit eternal life. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first." The Gospel of the Lord. Today we celebrate the queenship of the Blessed Virgin Mary, Queen of Heaven, for instance. I suppose most of us are aware of the 15th of August and it being the feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. If we pray the Rosary as part of our prayers, we're reminded of that feast day every time we come to the fourth glorious mystery. And when I was growing up in Ireland, August the 15th was a holy day of obligation, a harvest feast day, an important feast day in honor of Mary. I was never told that August the 22nd was the feast of the queenship of the Blessed Virgin Mary. Maybe we didn't need to be reminded. If we said the glorious mysteries of the Rosary, we came across the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary every Wednesday and Saturday. So today's feast of the Queenship of Mary was established by Pope Pius XII in 1954. I was alive then. Some of you were, I'm sure. We venerate Mary as queen for two reasons: her unique role in our redemption, and also because she is the first among the saints. Pope Pius XII put it this way: like her son before her, she conquered death and was raised body and soul into heaven, where as queen, she sits in splendor at the right hand of God. So we honor her in our Litany of the Rosary as we ask her to pray for us. The number of times we address her as Queen, Queen of Angels, Queen of Patriarchs, Queen of Prophets, Queen of Apostles, Queen of Martyrs, Queen of Confessors, Queen of Virgins, Queen of all saints, Queen conceived without original sin, Queen assumed into heaven, Queen of the Most Holy Rosary, Queen of Peace. And then again, we honor her in our prayers. The Hail Mary was probably the first prayer you and I were taught, and the first prayer maybe that you taught your children. We include that prayer in the Angelus. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived by the Holy Spirit. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to thy word. And then, of course, there's the Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy. We pray to Mary as Mother of God. We pray to Mary as Son of God, as Daughter of God, and Mother of Jesus. We can pray to her also as Hail, Queen of Heaven. Please stand for our intercessory prayers. May our soul magnify the Lord and our spirit rejoice in God our Savior. We pray to the Lord. That God may enrich our families with the blessing of newborn children. We pray to the Lord. For those in our daily Mass community who have asked to be remembered in our prayer, in our intentions book, especially those who have saved us, who have asked us to pray for health of mind and body. For them, on this day, we pray to the Lord. And for our own particular intentions at this time, we pray to the Lord. And let us pray together on this feast day, the Hail Mary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have received the word, the water and wine we offer you. May they be blessed by you in this Mass.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. As we observe this memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary, we bring you our offerings, O Lord, praying to be given strength by the humanity of Christ, who offered himself to you on the cross as the unblemished offering. He lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, to praise your mighty deeds in the exaltation of all the saints, and especially as we celebrate the memory of the Blessed Virgin Mary, to proclaim your kindness as we echo her thankful hymn of praise. For truly, even to earth's ends, you have done great things and extended your abundant mercy from age to age. When you looked on the lowliness of your handmaid, you gave us through her, the author of our salvation, your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts by sending down your Spirit upon them, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, Jesus took bread, and giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, our bishops, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her husband, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
The moment of receiving the risen Christ in Holy Communion draws near. We pray as we prepare ourselves by praying his prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, from every evil. Grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer one another that peace of the Lord.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Having received this heavenly sacrament, we humbly pray, O God, that we who reverently celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Virgin Mary may merit to be partakers at your eternal banquet through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Let us go from this Mass in the peace of Christ.
Our thanks to our donors for the gift of this Mass.
Hail Queen of...
Remember, if you can't sponsor a Mass, any contribution, no matter how small, will help keep Daily Mass on television. And you'll receive an income tax receipt for your donation.
Below, prone on life's earth.